My name's Nigel Eady. I'm part of the project management team working on Southeast Asia project. Currently we're in the lowlands. It's going to be the tiger habitat. In here, we're in the visitor shelter. There's going to be a roof over it, and there's going to be lots of glass. This is where we're going to see our tigers up close. We've got three different areas for the tigers. They're connected by aerial pathways up and over the public. It's going to be amazing to be underneath the tigers. So all these poles you see here, they've been positioned to give the boundaries for each of the tiger spaces. Over that side, all the meshes starting to be woven and connected to the lacing rods. So we've chosen this mesh from overseas. It's a proven product and we know it works. Here's one of the tiger dens. There's four of them in this habitat. We're recreating them out of concrete, essentially, shaping them up to make them look like fallen rock and caves. It's a complex process. You've got to have skilled themers to do the work to make it look realistic. Without hooking up the crane at the moment onto the tiger bridge, it takes a huge amount of adjustment to get so they can lift the structure and fit it in the right place. They've just spun it around. That's how it's going to be lifted onto its foundations. Big milestone for me personally, but I think it's the same. Everyone can say the same. It's a milestone for everybody. And when we get deliveries like this, it starts all coming together.
Hello, I'm Warren Spencer. I'm the senior curator of mammals here at Auckland Zoo. This is kind of a tiger eye view. They'll be able to look down and our visitors will pass from the shelter underneath on their way to otters. So we have two tiger overpasses. As it turns, as it rotates, that aperture, like a pepper pot, sends the clothes. So it'll enable us to actually have a circle where we can transition tigers or give them access all the way from one habitat throughout all three of them, or we can isolate them in particular habitats. So it really does give us a lot of flexibility. I want to introduce you to our tiger tree. So the idea behind this is that we'll be able to attach food rewards at certain points up this tree, all the way to the top. The idea that the tiger will be able to go up, grab that reward and come back down. It's just great for muscular skeletal development, and they'll really enjoy doing that as well. We have a seep that's running into a pool that meets a waterfall that's cascading down onto these rocks and filling these pools. I have no doubts that the tiger will be using a lot of this rock work and they'll have a lot of fun being in the water, paddling around and probably taking the sun on that beach area there. We've packed through the entire area with complexity. The reason that we've provided so much is we want to give the tigers choice. It's their habitat. They decide where they want to be.
Welcome along to our brand new tiger house. It's a fantastically designed functional space. So not only does it allow us to get nice and close to our tigers, allows us to do training for the physical health benefits, but also it's a really nice, warm, safe space for them to be in. So the way that the house is designed, we can actually bring a tiger into the chute, so we can have people on both sides. So if we need to do any sort of training on one side or the other, we bring the tiger through the chute, shut them in, do whatever we need to do, and then they can off they go on their merry way. One of the great new features of this house is the biofloor that we've got. It's got many, many uses. It's got really good drainage. It's easily cleanable. But the most important feature is it's actually very soft on their paws. So it's a naturalistic substrate. It's good for their foot health. And also it's nice and soft if they just want to lie down. I'm super, super excited. We're going to be getting a tiger in here in a few weeks' time. So after 3 years of planning, going back and forth, developments, meetings, it's just going to be such a range of emotions when they finally arrive and we actually get to see them out and about in what we've designed for them.
Okay, let's go. It's just a little after 20 past six in the morning. We're here at Auckland Airport and we're waiting for our tigers, Ramah the male and Zayana the female, to be offloaded so we can take a look at them. You know, you work for years for something like this, then one day it happens. It's a big day. It's such an exciting day. We've all been waiting for this and there's so many people that have been involved. I think we've been talking about this transport now for a little over 2.5 years.
Hello, darling. Hello.
Yeah.
This might be Zayana. Yeah, this is Zayana. And that's Ramah. So the male is called Ramah. He's around 5 years old. And the female, Zayana, she's just over four. And so these two cats have never met before. Ramah is from Oklahoma Zoo and Zayana from Topeka Zoo. They will have probably been able to detect each other over the transport because their two crates are quite close together, but they're yet to formally meet, and that's something that the team will be working over the weeks and the months to come.
Hello.
Looks really relaxed and settled and calm, so I'm very happy. Okay, now to the zoo.
I had a quick little peep inside just to check that they're all right, that they're still bright and alert. Zayana's looking very cute and very shy. Ramah's looking very alert, obviously he's looking out, seeing what's going on. So plan from here is to offload them. So we'll try and offload Zayana first into her quarantine area. Then Ramah will get put into his quarantine area. And yeah, we'll monitor them. So they'll be in there for 7 days in what we call their isolation period. And then after that, hopefully then we can move Zayana back over to the new tiger facility, and that's where they'll finish off their quarantine. Come on, Ramah. Ooh, there we go. It's been a couple of weeks since the new tigers have arrived at Auckland Zoo, so we're slowly settling them into life here. So it's a lot of relationship building, getting them to know who we are as people, how our voices sound, how we move, just so that they know that, you know, every time we arrive that something positive is going to happen. For example, with Ramah, we are doing training, then it's completely voluntary whether he wants to do that. Obviously, cats are quite food motivated, which is lucky for us, so he gets a nice treat out of it, and we get to see him and sort of do that relationship work that way. If the tiger wants to come over and participate, it's completely up to them. We using a target stick, getting him to move at different points along the wall, getting him to stand up, checking his underbelly, checking the pads of his paws. As you can see, his paws are a little bit grubby today. They've left quite a few marks on the wall, but that's all right. That's all part of the fun of it.
Good.
It'll be really cool for our guests who get to come in and see this sort of amazing work that we do with our animals here at the zoo. So it's all done for the welfare and health of the animal. So yeah, it's an awesome, awesome feature. So as part of our tiger management, we are going to be moving Ramah from one habitat to another one. So the habitat where we've done our training, we're then going to use our tiger bridges and get him across into our lowlands habitat where he's going to have to find and enjoy his breakfast. So when you do come to see our lovely tigers here at Auckland Zoo, just take time to really take in everything that's around you. So the whole immersive design, just really take time to have a look for the tiger. You know, they might be hiding in one, they might be having a sleep somewhere in the grass, in the thicket. Just get immersed in the whole experience. As you're walking through the entrance, have a look through the bamboo, have a look into the rock dens, and you know, be lucky to see a tiger, unless they see you.